Okay, cool. What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 2 of the CR podcast. I'm Rudy. And we have with me tonight, we have Nandos and a special guest, Money Mitsu.
Hey, guys.
wait to introduce yourself. But so tonight we're gonna be it's gonna be a little chill, you know. A lot of our players have gone back, just, you know, home from school. The season's over. I think yesterday's bracket was the last bracket for the season.
I believe so.
Yeah, that was a really cool one. We got 35 entrants for MSM, which is I think the biggest one they've gotten, right?
Yeah. It's the biggest local bracket we've had.
Wow.
Was it bigger than the one PL?
At the beginning of the semester?
PL's was 33, I believe, while Rascals was 35.
Oh, wow.
Man, that's actually insane.
It would have been bigger, but people just wanted to go home.
Yeah, true. That's true. I mean, we had Lyrex, which rocked.
The legendary Lyrex?
We had the legendary Lyrex.
Super the one Lyrex. And
only who didn't make it to Zero Saga, which is a huge topic for our podcast, which was insane. It was an insane tournament.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
So
upsets everywhere.
Upsets everywhere.
Oh, so are we starting with that?
But, sorry about that. So, yeah, upsets everywhere. I watched a good portion of that tournament. It put off studying. Never put off studying. But just to watch the tournament, and it was just insane. It was definitely something that everybody was looking forward to this whole year. Because, you know, everybody had, like, a saga. Abadongo had a saga. The Katar saga. Pink Fresh saga. And so this was definitely one that everybody was just really looking forward to. I know I was looking forward to it because of the one event they had, the Zero Run Back, which was, I don't know about you guys, but I feel like it was a little lackluster.
It's only because, like, they didn't do everybody that took a set off of them. Because there were some players that, like, they, I think some from the East Coast, like, they didn't get to the venue because their flight was delayed, so... I don't think they did everybody.
Like, I know did Ally compete in that?
Ally did. He came in the last second.
Yeah.
Mm. But even that was a little disappointing because of jet lag and whatnot. Mm. You know, I expected to be a little more hype. I know the Mr. E set was really hype.
I saw a little bit of that. It was, yeah. He made it really close.
He made it really, really close.
It really sucks that he didn't do that well.
Yeah. Yeah, he's been doing really well lately, too, though.
Completely outshined by MKLeo.
Yep.
Oh, man. That kid.
He lost to JK and Rich Brown, I want to say.
Yeah.
JK's a good Bayonetta from SoCal.
He's from
Vegas. JK's a great Bayo.
Vegas. He's from Vegas. He's actually PR number one of Vegas over Foe at the moment.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
He was on the SoCal PR last time I checked.
Really?
I really think he's from SoCal because there was one MSM from SoCal I was watching, and it was him and Elegant in Grand Finals.
Hmm. Well, I saw a Vegas PR with JK on it, and he was number one on it over Foe. But I'm not, whatever.
Yeah, it's whatever. It's whatever. But yeah, Mr. E definitely been doing good lately, but didn't really show up that much. At the Zero Saga. Still, shout out to him being a great Marth. He got 49th, actually.
That's still not too bad,
you know. And he lost to two great players, you know.
Yeah, he did. I mean, you can't really be mad about that. I know Tarzan talks about that, you know, whenever he loses a bracket, he's like, well, I lost to two really good players. I'm like, oh, yeah, you can't really be mad.
That's my problem, too.
I mean, I agree with that, because I feel like I never get... Like, I've been getting better, and I know yesterday Mitsu told me I played well, and OT told me I played well at Uprising, but, you know, I just feel like I never get the wins that I don't usually get. You know, that's just what that's where I am right now. But hey,
you're we're really all here close to get better. Taking that set over me, man.
I know it was really close. I was watching it at work yesterday night, and I was like, oh, I see.
Can we talk about Leo's bracket run?
Oh my god, oh, goodness!
Sick loser run. He 3-0 6 WX. He 3-0 Komer Kiri. Loses 3-2 to Void. Then
shout out to Void.
Yeah, I think Void's playstyle is like really good against Leo because Leo like really capitalizes on you not being like, especially on the Sheik matchup. If you see him versus Mr. R like takes forever. He has so much trouble killing Leo. So like Leo takes advantage of that like so hard. But with Void has like the most creative kill setups.
Oh yeah.
If you saw Void and Leo, like he killed him with a cross up air at like 80. Mm-hmm. And that was huge, you know.
Oh yeah, definitely. That was a really early stock.
Yeah. So I do think Leo does better in that matchup, like as of right now. But you know, Leo did get his run back and he did 3-0 him.
Oh yeah. So he pretty much 3-0'd like everybody.
Yeah, it was pretty
everybody he fought in top 8 was 3-0'd except for Ally. Ally took a game off him and Larry took some games off of him.
Yeah.
Larry got
3-0'd 0 at his own saga. The curse continues, man.
No, the curse is it lives forever because there's no more player sagas.
Right.
Oh, you're right. That's 2GG championship.
That's just crazy. Like, I don't know. I don't know where I would put Leo now because I put him at top 2. I'd still put 0
as number first. 1.
Yeah, I still put 0 number 1. Either top 2 or top 3.
I'd give him 3 if anything because Ally, I believe Ally should be second.
I think Ally should be third.
The thing with Ally is he's been becoming a lot more. If you look at his results, his results doesn't really support like a top 3 placing. Like if you look at his results so far, you know, it doesn't really support him being top 3 in my opinion. If you look, cuz like he got 13th at UGC. He got 49th at the Big House.
I think he left Big House early.
Yeah, he
had to leave Big House early.
That's, I mean, like when you think about PGR, they a lot of like
they consider placements, yeah, but it, I it, also it, believe it, they consider the wins over the top 10.
Yeah,
and he's had pretty solid wins over a lot of the top 10. One being the best player in the world, he's got a lot of wins over 0 now.
Yeah,
I think it's like 5-1
right now. I think so.
Wait, is it? No, wait. I want to.
Here, I can find.
You're right. He beat him OTK. He beat him once at 8 end game. I remember that one.
Oh yeah. That one set he beat him at end game. But ever since then, it's been kind of Ally's game. I mean,
that's true.
This one was really close. Yeah. It's usually really close. I mean, that set was super hype. I was like freaking out when I was watching it. Like I don't know. I can't like just really quick about the Civil War. I can't even really pick a team because like I love Zero, I'm an Ally, man.
I'm definitely on Team Ally for sure.
Like I'm leaning more to Team Ally, but like I love Zero. But shoot, I'm just looking at this bracket too, and Ally kind of had a good run until he met Larry in Winners.
The thing is, he beat Zero to get into top 8 qualifier, mm-hmm. but then got double eliminated in top 8.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah, that's also what I was about to, like, you know.
That's true.
Touch up on, you know. He does have personal demons. Like I think Larry is becoming one of his demons now because I think Larry's learned a Mario matchup. Like he really, if you watch him play, like he he just out, he's completely outplays Ally like in the neutral, and it's like he just waits for Ally to do.
I still think Ally has a strong record over Larry though.
Yeah, but I think
it kind of went back and forth. It did go back and forth.
I think Larry has the edge.
He has the edge right now, but if you remember, Newfish, Larry won that over Ally.
He took two sets, and then Larry, and then Ally won again on my level over Larry, and then
I believe after that at the Rio Abasaga. Games, right?
Oh yeah, Rio Games beat Larry, Ally, and then Abasaga, Larry took it.
Yeah, Larry started taking it. So ever since then, Larry has been like has had the edge.
Right. Mm. I think I give the edge to Larry at the moment, but
I wouldn't know where to put Larry though.
I think Larry's top five.
He's definitely top five. I think you got to think about Salem.
No, I think
Salem
I think
is good. Don't get me wrong, but his placings at majors
have not been great. Good. Okay, I see.
I think because he got 13th at. Okay, let's say he got 13th at Big House. He got 17th at UGC and Serial Saga. What else?
Team's it. His personal demon is the Buzz.
Buzz, yep. Mm. Never been the Buzz once.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
He almost beat him, but then the Buzz reversed 3-0'd him at Zero Saga.
I think Salem has a really good record against the top 10, but I think his results in general just like don't support a top 10 player.
Yeah,
like, okay. I think he would be like top 15 or so, you know.
I can see him being top 15.
Top 15, like, yeah.
Yeah.
I think he'll take Leo's old spot. I feel like
probably, maybe. But time will tell. I think it will be this is really it's hard to make this top 10 list, to be honest, cuz
it's very hard, yeah.
The Buzz and Nyrule gotta be in there somewhere.
Let's just throw the main people that are definitely gonna be in top 10. Like, let's think of 10 players. So Nyrule, the Buzz, like Mitsu just said. I'd say Komori Void.
Kiri and Mr. R.
Komori Kiri, Mr. R. Void. Zero, obviously, Ally and MK Leo. So what are we at? 8?
I'd say Anti still.
Larry and Anti too. So that's 10.
Yes.
So that's 10. So
I think
Undisputed, we say 0, right?
Yeah, yeah. I think 0 is still, like, it's the results are there, so.
Yeah, okay.
But also, we have to remember, like, when it comes to Ally versus MKLeo, right? I'm pretty sure Ally has more entries than MKLeo does.
That's true. But that would also mean we would have to like punish the Buzz also, because the Buzz doesn't have recent results. Like as of recent, his only results are 5th at Big House, 13th at KTAR, and then 9th at Zero Saga.
Mm-hmm.
Like those are his only results in the past few months.
Yeah.
And if you want to date back even further, you can go 2nd at Super Smash Con and then 7th at Evo.
Yeah, those are all like all around the same placings.
Yeah, but I would like
13th.
Right.
But okay. So yeah, that does arise a problem. But I still feel like I still kind of agree with Nando's. It's very tough. I feel like it's a toss up between Ally and Leo for me for number 2. But whoever's not number 2 is definitely number 3. Number 3, I think.
In my honest opinion, I'd give it to Ally because the dude won Evo, you know, the biggest tournament of the year.
That gets him a lot under his belt.
That's true in a sense. I think I give it to you. Results wise, I definitely give it to Ally.
He won Evo from Winners.
Yeah.
Also think about that.
That is true. I think I would put Zero and then Ally, but honestly, I put Leo right after him.
Because, yeah, Leo definitely.
So then, what is the actual PGR?
What do you mean?
No, like, because, you know, I think it was during Big House when they were showing the players that were ranked. And I'm pretty sure Zero was number one and Nairo was number two. Have they updated that at all?
No.
It's actually kind of outdated. I'm looking at it right now. It says January 2015.
I think it's very, very outdated.
Yeah, it's very, because it says January 2015 to May 2016.
Hmm.
And we're about to end this year. And under characters for Zero, he still has Sheik.
Oh, okay. So yeah, it's definitely outdated.
It's definitely outdated. Like, this whole thing has been shooken up. I know Renai, he's definitely not top 10 anymore. He has had no showings.
Yeah,
except for like Evo, I think.
Fighter.
Street Fighter took him from us.
would it be dumb to put Nairo over to Buzz? And
no, I don't think so.
I don't think it'll be dumb at all.
I don't think
Like Nairo, he did have like a cold streak, but he's been back at it recently and been getting top eights and stuff.
He's also had a perfect attendance. Also, I mean, the last one he had a perfect attendance, and I think this one. He has had one too.
Let's see. Okay, the Zero Saga, he got what, fifth, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, fifth at so. Zero Saga. He got, I think he got fourth at UGC, if I recall correctly. Because he lost to East Ham.
Mm-hmm.
He got seventh at Big House. That's pretty decent, I guess. The fourth, I mean,
these
and
are
fifth
all
are
really,
really
good placings.
Yeah.
The seventh is good too. Like for tournaments as stacked as these, you know?
Yeah.
Nairo is no slouch.
I mean, any top eight would be great.
I think it all depends on like how they would weight certain tournaments. Because like say fifth, fourth, and seventh, that they're pretty good, but then he got first at Super Smash Con. But we don't know if like how they would weigh in Super Smash Con. You know.
You also have to think about how he did at Evo.
What did he get? 17? No, 13. 13.
Yeah.
Larry.
This isn't terrible.
That's not too bad.
Didn't Zero also get 13th at Evo?
No, CEO, I think. Or 9th.
Zero got 9th at CEO. Third at Evo.
Third at Evo. Because he also kept
13th at Smash Con.
Yeah, that's where he got 13th. Because I remember them saying that was his lowest tournament placing of all time.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Thanks to Ally.
Stupid Ally.
So far, we have Zero. We have Ally. We have MKLeo. And then Nairo.
It's either between Nairo, the Buzz, or Void.
I would have to give that to Nairo.
You would put Void above Larry?
Hmm?
Said you would put Void above Larry?
Void's results are more consistent than Larry's.
Mm.
That's true.
Like, at Big House, Void got 4th while Larry got 17th. Larry got, at Evo, Void got 4th while Larry got 7th. Let's see. I think CEO. Okay, CEO is the only one where Larry outplaced him. UGC, Larry got 7th and Void got 5th. I think overall, Void's results are higher than Larry's, in my opinion.
Okay. Okay, I'll give him that. So, That's tough because I really feel like fourth should go to Nairo.
Yeah, I think it's a tie between those three. It's just.
So would we say that for like, so like, what about fifth? What about like, forget about fourth, but what about fifth? Like,
yeah, it'll probably be Abadongo.
Okay, Abadongo for fifth,
but not Mr. R, because I know Mr. R is super good.
Mr. R's results has been pretty lackluster lately.
Yeah, they've been really sporadic.
And it's like it really sucks because, like, I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, he did just lose to Locust. I don't think he got top 8.
He got
Locust was on fire.
Oh my gosh.
I don't know what that. I don't know what his deal is. Like, he's. Oh, that was just a weird gameplay. He has such a weird play style.
It was well, no, I think it was actually very effective. I think it was great because, like, what's Ryu's big problem? Like, people can outcamp him, and he has to chase people that are faster than him. Like, literally, all Locust did was walk after Mr. R and throw out up tilt. Like, that's what I noticed. And he just waited for him to slip up.
Yeah. So, I think, okay, so his results so far, okay, recency, 17th at Zero Saga, 9th at UDC, 7th at, no, no, it's not 7th, 4th at Big Hells, which is actually really good. He got 17th at Evo, he got 5th at CEO, and then he got 3rd at SmashCon.
Okay.
So, well, I mean, I still put him at top 10, but his recent results doesn't help him.
It kind of is hurting him. I feel like, I don't know, this top 10 is going to be, like, so different. Like, from, like, the recent one. I mean, a lot of them, all of the top 10 are still going to be there, but, you know, we're going to have MKLeo now.
Hold on, let me gather around the buzz.
And Kimura Kiryu wasn't even top 10.
If we can go back to the number 4 spot and number 5, I'd go Nairo, then Void.
I can kind of agree with that.
I can definitely agree with that too.
Nairo, Void. I mean, what are I, cuz like there's also like the other thing, like, you know, their wins over the top 10.
I also think it's cuz of his win in SmashCon, but it's still like It just depends on how they weigh certain tournaments.
Yeah. But yeah, like, let's think about, like, the wins of the top 10, though. Like, Nairo, I think, has more wins over the top 10 this season than Void.
And who has Nairo really lost? He lost to Zero.
He's really Salem, only lost to Zero.
He's also beaten Salem afterwards.
Huh?
So he also beat Salem at a Big House, I believe it was.
He also lost to Salem at K-Tar.
Yeah, but, you know, Big House was after that, so he got his revenge.
Wait, was it?
Yeah. Nairo's because remember, also... if you oh, remember, Collision and was yeah, Collision so was means, Salem's so like means, breakout so, performance.
So that means no. So that means Salem's up in sets against Nairo.
Yeah, I think it's like 2-1.
Yeah.
Right, okay.
So he's lost to, who was it? Zero, Salem, ESAM. I don't know who else.
Oh, yeah.
Do him and Larry or Ally ever really meet in bracket?
Who?
Nairo.
I think Nairo hasn't been Larry since Evo.
Because I know Nairo was up in sets against Void.
Yeah, it's like 5-1 now.
He's up in sets against Koma Rukiri, I believe, right?
Koma just recently beat him at Big House.
Yeah. This is hard.
This is very hard.
Because you look at the result, okay, this is for... Okay, okay, for the buzz, we have 7th at Evo, 3rd at CEO, 5th at Big House, 13th at K-Tar, 9th at Zero Saga, and then 2nd at Super Smash Con. For Nairo, we have... Hold on. 1st at Smash Con, 13th at Evo, 5th at Zero Saga, 4th at Big House, and then 7th at Big House, and then 4th at UDC.
What did you get at K-Tar?
Yep, 4th. So Oh, he got also got the CEO. I think he got 13th as CEO.
Okay.
This is actually
when it comes to people like Zero and Nairo, like obviously Zero's been doing well. Like
after his hand injury, he's really back on top again.
But I remember like when he first came back, you know, he was a little off, but you know, he was still decent, right?
Yeah.
But as of recent, he's been on fire and doing what Zero does.
Mm-hmm.
But if you take that out of the equation, right, and if you just look at Zero and Nairo, I believe that their past results carry a heavy weight on with those two players. Because those two were like the debatable 1 and 2 of Smash 4, you know, Zero and Nairo. Mm-hmm. We always thought either one of them were going to win. So, and their past placings speak for itself. And I think, you know, a lot of people like to put them still in the same category because of their past placings.
But you have to look at now, though.
I think
7th to 5th is like his normal placing now.
Yeah, which isn't bad at all.
No, yeah, it's definitely not bad at all. But it just means that he's just not second best anymore.
Mm-hmm. Second best is like really up in the air because usually really these guys trade sets with each other, except for with the exception of, you know, some people being each other's personal demons.
Yeah, it's like that's one reason I feel like second. Maybe there's like a lack of just like wins over the top 10, which like I think Void has. I mean, like he's definitely not second, but like I mean, like there's just like so many factors that just make it really hard to give a solid second. So it's gonna really be, I think it's gonna really be controversial, or and just very like surprising who they pick as second. I mean, it could be MKLeo, it could be Ally, but I don't know. But I just really feel like it's going to be like a controversial thing.
Yeah. So.
But so far for us, we have. Wait, what were you saying, Andos?
I think. Okay, in my opinion, I think Nairo and the Buzz's peaks are higher. But I think Void has this more consistency overall. In my opinion,
yeah, especially as of recent,
because if you see the Buzz and Nairo, like Nairo got first at Smash Con, he got fourth at KTAR, which is like really good. The Buzz got second at Smash Con, but he also got like 9th at Zero Saga and then 13th at KTAR. But if you see Void, his lows aren't that bad. Like his consistency is really solid. He got 4th at Smash Con, 3rd at Zero Saga, 5th at UTC, 4th at CEO, 9th at CEO, 5th at Big House, and then 9th at Alba Saga.
Hmm. And Nairo's the one that kept him out of top 8, right?
At Alba Saga?
Yeah.
No, it was Elegant.
Oh, man, Elegant. Oh, yeah.
It was Nairo and Elegant.
Yeah, Nairo and Elegant. Man, that was an upset. That was a real upset.
Yeah.
Didn't Elegant beat Abadongo that day too?
Yeah.
Yes. Wait, Abadongo lost to a Dr. Mario and then Elegant, right?
Yeah.
Jeez.
So man, I personally wouldn't be surprised if they put Void at 4th just because of his consistency.
Yeah, but we could do that.
I'd say Nairo, Void 4th.
But Nairo and DaBuzz probably have more wins over the top 10, and they have higher peaks. So I still wouldn't be surprised if they got the 4th spot as well. So
if anything, I would still say Nairo just because of his wins over the top 10.
Hmm. Yeah.
That's true. But then again, I think he's the only one
No.
No, he's the only one in the top 10 so far that hasn't taken a set off of zero since he came back, except Brunei and Abadango.
Okay, yeah.
If I recall correctly, he's the only one that hasn't been zero since the last PGR came out.
I think so. Yeah, I think so.
That kind of hurts him.
It hurts him a lot. I mean, man, if he gets that set one over zero before the year is up, who knows?
No, I think it's already over. The BGR comes out on the 3rd or the 5th of January.
Oh, it does? What?
Yeah.
Oh, snap. It
comes out right before Genesis.
And I heard our boy Wizzy's going to be up there.
They'd make a top 100. That's what I heard.
Yeah, he was telling me that, like, on the way back from Guts. But shoot, yeah, this PGR is going to be insane. I'm actually very excited to see it.
Okay, so I'm gonna put Naira fourth for now. However,
Void fifth. I think I give fifth.
Void will probably be fifth, and then DeBuzz.
DeBuzz sixth.
Yeah, DeBuzz sixth.
So number seven
is between. Okay, so we have three spots left, right? 7, 8, 9.
Yeah, 10, we have Mr. R, Koma, Rikiri, and Anti. Or we're missing and Larry.
I think it'll be Anti, Abadango, Larry, and Mr. R.
Okay, well, I'm definitely putting Larry for next.
Let's see, Larry
for sixth. Yeah. I think give him that.
Let's see Larry's results. There's Larry got 7th at Evo, right? You got 7th at CEO. He didn't go to SmashCon. You got 5th at Shine. Big House, he got 17th, which is actually, I kind of hurts him, in my opinion.
It does, but
yeah.
And then he got 7th at UGC, but then he got 2nd at Zero Saga.
I honestly think that that 17th gets heavily outweighed, though, because if we're being honest, Larry's results are slightly worse than Void, while Larry has wins over the top 10.
But I think when I'm going back and thinking about, like, all the videos I watched, I think they're considering consistency a little bit.
Yeah, and Larry's really consistent. He only had, you know, one bad showing, which is the 17th.
But I think Void. So
I think that, it's only because Void's consistency level is higher than Larry's.
Yeah, and that's why I said, you know, Larry's results are slightly worse than Void's.
Yeah.
So we give. So yeah, I think we give that edge to Void.
Okay. All right. We got
well, Larry's the real question though is, would we put DeBuzz over Larry?
I put DeBuzz over Larry.
I don't know.
I think I would put. I would definitely put DeBuzz over Larry.
What's your reasoning?
His results. 5th at Big House, 2nd at SmashCon. What else? 7th at Evo. 3rd at CEO. And 2nd at SmashCon.
Okay, yeah, I see that.
Yeah.
But he didn't make 9th. He only got 9th at Zero Saga.
Yeah.
Recency,
maybe. Out of recency, I would definitely put Larry over DeBuzz. But
out of all time. Yeah. Okay,
because,
I see that.
Because
now.
If you look at DeBuzz's recent results, like,
he's had better results at the beginning.
He doesn't have that many results, and those results themselves, like, they kind of hurt him. Like, getting 13th at KTAR, and then 9th at Zero Saga, and then 5th at Big House.
Yeah. Okay.
But so if you look at his past results, like dating back to Evo,
he's been pretty good.
Yeah.
Getting first at What the Fox.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He did get first at What the Fox.
He got first at Apex. Third at CEO.
First at Apex.
So, okay. Yeah, I give that. I definitely put the buzz over Larry now, looking at his results.
Yep. So, I think the next spot will be a tie between Larry and Abba. And Abba is an oddball. Like
Abba is such an oddball. You're right. I totally agree with
you
that.
Yeah, 13th is at his own saga. You got 9th, like, zero saga. You got 2nd at UGC. And he got 9th at Big House. He got 5th at Evo. 5th at Evo, and then I think he got 4th at CEO. If I recall correctly. Or
yeah.
I think it was fourth.
Let's see. I'm gonna date back to all right. So like just looking at from this summer, I feel like this summer is definitely like a big factor for everybody. He got 5th at Smash and Splash, 4th at CEO, like you said. Evo 5th, okay. Also said. SmashCon 7th.
Okay, SmashCon 7th.
I don't know if they're considering Umabara, but he got 13th there.
He doesn't do really well in Japan. That kind of hurts him.
Yeah, that definitely does hurt him. I mean, he did get 2nd at Umabara 25, but SAT was a bigger tournament. Right. 13th at his own saga. Big House 9th. He missed top 8 for that.
Yep.
I don't think he got went singles for one of the Umabara. So like we're just gonna completely forget about Japan. But UGC he got 2nd.
Yeah, that kind of helps him, but
not as much as
I would want. Okay, so this is Larry's results. He got 2nd at Zero Saga. 7th at UGC, but 3rd at Olympus, 17th at Big House, 2nd at Abba Saga, 5th at Shine, 4th at KTAR Saga, 7th at Evo, 7th at CEO, 1st at Mexico Saga, where's Evo? Yeah, 7th at Evo and 7th at CEO. So I think I definitely give it to...
I give it to Larry.
Mm-hmm.
And also, I think it's also because of Larry's wins over the top 10.
Yeah, Abba doesn't have as many. Yeah, definitely. Abba doesn't have as many under his belt.
Like, I think Abba's wins over the top 10 are more, like, they're, like, more based on, like, his wins over... Mr. R, The Buzz, and Void.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because like I said, he's never been zero. I think he only has one win over Nairo. And then Larry Lur, obviously.
Yeah.
But that's the only thing that kind of like makes it hard as well.
Wait, hold on. I'm just checking something really quick. As of December 2016. Oh, so... This year hasn't been... Oh, there's also one really bad blemish.
What?
For Abadongo, and that's 49th at Genesis 3.
But Genesis was for the last PGR.
Was it considered for last PGR?
I think that this PGR will be from CEO onwards.
Oh, CEO onwards. Okay, I didn't know that. So I was looking at all the other tournaments.
Right. No, that's fine.
Okay, well...
So I think I put Larry and then Abba.
Abba is 8. Now, two more we have to consider. There's Anti and Mr. R.
Anti
won CEO. But
Anti did win CEO.
His top eight wasn't as stacked as most top eights are. I mean, he got his grand finals win over Zenodo, which I'm not putting Zenodo down. He's a great player, but he's also kind of inconsistent.
And didn't he also beat DeBuzz at CEO?
He did, and that's a really good win. But like, grand finals was between him and Zenodo. Mm. Was that? Does Zenodo win it from winners? I mean, get there from winners, I think.
No, he got them from losers. He lost the buzz in semis and then made it back to losers.
Okay. And reset the bracket on Anti, I believe, right?
Yeah, he took us off.
Okay. Got it. So Anti.
I'm looking it up right now.
Let's see. Too.
The immortal.
Let's see. Anti. Okay. You got 7th at Zero Saga, 13th at UGC, 2nd at Smashdown, 4th at Olympus, 2nd at Big House, which is really good.
That's really, really good.
9th at Abba Saga, 17th at Shine, 13th at SmashCon, 33rd at Evo, but then you got 1st at CEO.
Those are really good placings.
Those are some really, really good placings.
Yes, but... it's weird with him because, like
you Shine, for example, where he lost off stream, I believe, right?
Yep.
You know, and I feel like him losing off stream isn't like, you know, I feel like it happens.
Yeah, that's true. It does happen. But let's see. I'm going to look at Mr. R's results. So like, we had Anti's results up, but looking at Mr. R's results, I'm going to go from CEO. 5th at CEO. 2nd at What the Fox 2. Evo, he got 17th. K-Tar Saga, he got 5th. Smash Factor 5, 2nd to MKLeo, his demon. RIP. Smash Con, he got 3rd. Umobara, he got 5th. Big House, he got 4th. That was actually really good. That was actually a really good placing for him.
That's very good.
That's very good for Mr. R. UGC, he got 9th. Missed top 8 for that. And at Zero Saga, he got 17th, losing to MKLeo. Losing to Anti and Locus.
Yeah, it's very weird. Like, I think this might be the hardest.
I feel like these are two of the hardest. We've had a couple hard ones, but like,
okay,
these are two of the hardest.
Okay, let's look at their wins. I think Anti has
better wins. He has his win over Zero.
I'm trying to figure out how many wins he has over top 10.
I mean, he has a win over Zero, so that's one. That's a big one.
Yeah, that's true. He has multiple wins over Zero. He has no wins over Nairo. He has a set off of DeBuzz.
Has he ever beaten Ally before?
I don't think they hardly play.
No, Ally beat him at Get On My Level.
I hardly see them play.
He beat him at Get On My Level.
Okay.
I think he's negative with Abba Dango. I don't think he's beaten up Abba ever.
Okay.
He has no wins over Larry, actually. Very cold. Let's see.
That's tough.
I think, but he has like a perfect record against Void. I think it's like 4-0. Sheesh. And then I think he has a perfect record against Mr. R.
Yeah, okay. So...
But let's
I give I honestly I think I give it like thing hearing this I feel like Anti's results are just a little bit better than Mr. R, just by like a margin, and he also has better wins.
That's true. He's like he does have a higher peak, but Then again, he does have really, really low lows. But yeah, I guess I think I put that into consideration. I don't think I would be surprised if Anti was overall a star.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to give that to Anti and then Mr. R for the top 10. That is so tough. Oh my gosh, all these panelists. I understand, man. They're gonna have it really hard.
All right, so we have our top 10.
We have the CR's top 10 for the PGR being Zero, MKLeo, Ally, Nairo, Void, DeBuzz, Larry, Abadongo, Anti, and Mr. R. Oh man, that's a pretty good top 10. But who are we missing from the top 10 from the last top 10?
Didn't we agree for Ally being above MKLeo?
Yeah.
Oh,
did we? Okay.
We both put.
Okay, so we have Ally and MKLeo, but missing from the top 10, we have Renai. That's it.
Well, just because he doesn't go good or anything.
Yeah, that's the only reason why. I mean, there's a villager in the top 10. Think about that.
I think I still put him in the top 15.
I don't know, because the top 15 is actually going to look a lot different too. I think
it's going to be there. It's going to be Renai, Tweak, Mars, Salem, and Komorokiri or Kamamushi.
I'd say Kamamushi is
I'd say replace Renai with Kamamushi, because Renai hasn't been doing anything.
Okay, so I give. Okay, so that would be the top 15 right there. Foe is definitely not up there. Oh, shout out to Foe for coming back at the Zero Saga. That was actually pretty hype.
And getting what place did at, he like, get? 17th.
Dude, he got 17th, and he 3-0'd DeBuzz and I believe one of the Bayonettos.
He didn't 3-0 DeBuzz.
Oh no, not DeBuzz. What the heck am I talking about? I'm so stupid, guys. Let's edit that out. He 3-0'd K9. And Captain Zach, I just remember because they were saying he does not want to face DeBuzz. But then we had Fatality. Like, oh my gosh!
90-10 matchup.
90-10 matchup.
it's such a bad matchup. But poor Fatality, never getting his win over Larry. But he did get a really solid win over Foe, which was actually pretty hype. That set was hype.
I think Foe, his ranking will be definitely dropped off.
It's really gonna drop off a lot. Like, I mean, like a huge amount.
It showed at Zero Saga because they already saw that Foe didn't deserve a top 15 seed.
He definitely did not, but he kind of proved that he didn't make top 15, but he still kind of proved that he's around.
Okay,
and I think he's thinking about getting back into it.
If we put this top 15 into order, I'd say Komorokiri would be number 11.
Yeah, I would definitely.
Yep.
And then I think.
Oh, put, he's still number 11.
And I think I'd put either Kamamushi or Salem.
Yeah, because Salem's wins over the top 10 is absolutely insane.
Kamamushi also has a win over Zero.
So does Salem.
But Salem has multiple wins over Zero.
No,
Salem has wins against.
No, I think he beat him twice at Class City.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Two points.
So I give that to Salem.
He's beaten Zero. He's beaten Ally. He's beaten Nairo.
Not the Buzz. Never mind.
He hasn't beaten
Larry. He beat Larry.
Yeah, he beat.
Oh, he beat Larry.
He destroyed Larry.
Yeah,
that first set they played. Oh my gosh.
Oh Jesus, that was pretty ugly.
Guys, Smash is actually an anime.
And then I put Tweak at the bottom of top 15.
Yeah.
And then no. I think then Toby.
Well, it would be either Mars or Tweak. But if
Mars
being
has
honest,
really been turning up lately, so I give it to Mars.
But Tweak has been also playing fairly well. Like, not even just playing, but his results are decent.
Hey, let me look at Tweak's results really quick and compare them to Mars. How old is this kid?
I think
18. He's 18 years old.
I think I give the higher placing to Mars because Mars just has more results than Tweak.
Okay.
Hold on, really Tweak is like one of the more consistent players on a lower level.
Right.
Yeah, he doesn't really lose to anybody below him
much. I definitely still give it to Mars because like Tweak has been making top 8 at majors and Mars has like top 8 at Big House.
That's true.
That's actually big.
Yeah, so I definitely give it to Mars.
Did Katar Saga, was that counted for last year?
No, it's counted for this year.
Okay, so he got second at that.
Right. But Tweak can go to that. So like, that's still like he had more results than Tweak.
He also got 9th at UGC.
Mars? Okay,
so.
Yeah.
So we have Komo Rikiri, Salem, Kamimushi, Mars, and then
Tweak. That's our top 15.
Yeah. That sounds pretty accurate.
I like that. Unless
someone like wins a major, wins Genesis, that's like not top 15.
Oh my gosh. Shout out to Locust.
Oh my gosh.
don't forget Genesis Saga. That's a part of the 2GG championship.
Right.
I think that'll be weighted. I think that'll have some weight to it.
Right. It will.
I like this top 15.
Yeah.
All right, now to the more pressing topic. Our PR.
Right. I actually have like, it's very interesting because I think the only thing that matters right now is probably the top 5 in our PR. And no one's going to disagree with me when I say Wizzy's first and OT is second.
I do not disagree. I still feel like I will stand by this. Wizzy should be 0 until somebody beats him.
Right.
But like, maybe. We're not going to do that. And I'm fine with it. But I'm just saying, like, I feel like Wizzy should be 0. But yes, Wizzy is 1, OT is 2.
And the thing is, for the third place, I personally, and I don't think any of you guys would disagree either, but I think it's a tie between Mitsu, PF, and
Pat. No, I'll give it to Mits.
The thing is that PF has better wins. Like, I don't think Mitsu hasn't been OT yet. If I recall correctly.
PF did just get 2 wins.
PF has multiple wins over OT in the past season.
Anything like that, me and PF, we both went to one of the invasions and we both placed 17th. So out of region, we're fairly even. The same.
Yeah.
But there's one time where I got double eliminated because I was super sick while he got 13th place. You know, right. I'm very happy for him. But I did really bad.
I actually took note of your placings. I think I have.
Oh, snap! He came prepared.
I just like because the top 5 was so hard to put. Like I was.
Wait, you guys already discussed this?
I kind of discussed this a little bit with OT, but okay. If you look at his PLs from recent to less recent, he got 5th at a PL, 3rd at another one, 2nd at another one, and 5th at another one. But if you look at his results in MSM, he does have really, really clear dominance at MSM. Getting 1st at everything except one where he got 3rd and 2nd. And those are like the one he got 3rd, he got outplaced by PF and Wizzy, and then the second one was Wizzy. So
okay.
And PF
PF does well at his locals along with OT.
Let's see, okay. From recent to less recent, let's see, there's a 1st, 2nd, 4th, first, seventh, third, second, third, ninth. And then his MSMs are actually really, really shaky. Because from recent to last recent, this is like from recent to last recent. I'm talking about like from like now up until like, remember when the first PL with
all those people.
Yeah. So his MSMs are third, fourth, second, fifth, second, first, and fifth. And then the RPI monthlies are first, second, and third. Wow, Mitsu. Oh shit! Did you go to
go to
Rochester?
I went to one of the monthlies.
Well, what did you get?
I want to say either third or fourth.
Let's see. Okay. So, in my opinion, I definitely put Mitsu over PF.
I do too, but
I think like... PS wins are a lot better than Mitsu's. So that's just like, you know.
But we also have to consider his losses too.
PF?
I feel like, are we considering losses also?
We can consider losses as well.
I mean, but... I'm not bragging at all, but like he does have a loss to me this season.
Well,
he has a couple to Tarzan.
And then who else? I think he's lost to. He hasn't lost to Wonton. He lost to Primax, actually.
Yeah, he did.
He lost to Primax in the beginning. He lost to Primax in the beginning and recently. So.
Mm-hmm.
Mitsu, let's see.
My bad blemishes I know from the season, which was like really early on, which OS. Was losing to Boost OS. And OS, I believe. Actually, I don't know if I lost to Boost. I don't know if I lost to Boost this season or not.
I don't think
I do. It was last season. It was definitely last season. I remember that.
Yeah, because I know I have a positive record over Boost and Package for this season.
Really? I thought it was even.
Nah, I'm up in sets over both of them.
Okay.
And I have like an infinite to like two to against PF.
And everybody else.
Right. So
my only like real losses come from Wizzy, OT, and Marcel.
Right. Which is why I'm not worried about Marcel, because I'm gonna put Marcel as top five right now.
I don't know about Marcel being
he
top
might
five.
Not even be a part of it because of his inactivity.
He has right. such
but I, he doesn't I think, have it. I think he still deserves a spot in the PR because
he does,
like,
but it's just
like when he comes to events, like he doesn't disappoint. I mean, like,
well, that's true,
obviously he's not second best anymore, but he still like shows that he's like PR material.
Put it like this though, like last season I wasn't PR'd because I was pretty inactive, but every time I showed up, you know, it was like a top five placing. And so I was an honorable mention. And so you can't just go off of sheer, you know, oh, he's a good player, and that's why he should be PR'd. Because if that's the case, then I would have been PR'd last season, but I wasn't.
I think it's just because of... it's probably because it's like his previous ranking, you know?
Yeah, you know, you can't go off of, like, you know, the sheer power of someone's past results and how good of a player they are, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, no disrespect to Marcel. He's a really awesome player. He's a cool guy and stuff. But he's
inconsistent. Oh, my God. Yeah.
But what about his wins, too? Think about his wins.
Let's see.
I know he almost got a clean sweep on that one PL he showed up at.
I'm pretty sure it was a clean sweep.
No, Mitsu took a game off him.
I was the one that took a game off of him. That's right.
Yeah, that was insane.
I remember he got first at 1PL. I think it was the first one ever. Yeah, he won the whole thing. And then he got fifth at 1, if I recall, or 7th. Because I remember he lost to Gronk and then Wonton. I forget which one that was, though. So,
oh wait. So OT has been like chatting. Has been in the chat this whole time. I don't know if any of you have seen it.
What has he been saying?
So, like, the first thing he said, that invasion was this summer, so it won't count towards the PR, the one that So, PF and Mitsu at the invasion has tied this season, and KTAR where PF did mediocre, while Mitsu has uprising that PF no-showed where he did mediocre.
That's true. That actually brings more controversy.
So big tourney and out of region, Mitsu and PF are pretty much tied. Mitsu went to the second PL, I think he was talking about, where he got fourth, losing to Wizzy and me. Losses do count. He has one loss to Boos. Mitsu's biggest blemishes are Pat and Nito.
Oh yeah. I remember.
Yeah, I really hate you. Mitsu versus PF is 7-4 this season.
I hate you.
And then this is seventh. Grunken Wonton and RPI Monthly. That's all he said. Okay, so that brings up a lot. And what would be PF's biggest blemishes this season?
Losing to, I'm trying to think. I know there's one.
OT will bring it up, but so I'd say we have third and fourth. Pretty much figured out between PF and Mitsu. Oh, he lost to Grunken Wonton. That was his Oh no, Marcel got seventh at PL.
Yeah, seventh.
Losing to Grunken Wonton.
Yep.
I remember that.
Yeah, that was I remember that was the moment Wizzy showed up too, and then like after the PL I texted him, was like, yo, what the heck? Why weren't you in grand finals with Wizzy? It's like, oh man, I messed up. Like, yeah, you did. Now go home. Like, geez.
You done goofed.
You goofed real hard. But shout out to Grunk and Wonton. Shout out to Grunk. Oh man.
Yo, Grunk played absolutely insane that day.
Yeah, he did. I think he'd be packaged that day. There was another one.
Okay, so OT, who's constantly feeding information, says PS worst losses are to Primex and Rudy, me.
That's not super bad losses, to be honest.
Yeah, but his a lot worst record than my losses.
His worst record is 1-5 to package.
Is it really 1-5?
Yes. I remember I commentated the met like the set he finally beat him. He looked so happy.
He almost beat him just past Rascals, but package pulled the reverse 3-0 on him.
Oh yeah, he definitely did. That was insane. But okay. So in terms of losses, Mitsu, I say you have the worst blemishes.
Yeah.
But it's not by much.
It's not by much. Not by much.
Because what? It's OS and then what?
Like Nito and
Nito and Pat. Pat's great. Pat's a great player too.
That's okay. Nito, I hate you.
But then like PF lost to Primex, who doesn't show up too much, but still a great player.
Like I said, like this is like super debatable. Like I actually couldn't give the spot to either one of you because it's super hard.
It's very hard. But I'm gonna have to give third to Mitsu. I feel like Mitsu deserves third because of his dominance at MSM. His win. Well, he doesn't have really great wins. He still has wins.
To be honest, I don't even think Marcel had any good wins at Uprising. He got a CR bracket, I believe.
Oh,
I also got a pretty good win on Twister at Uprising.
Oh yeah, Twister. Yeah, okay.
He CR'd in Syracuse. That's pretty good. But Marcel got a CR bracket because he had to play Tarzan. He lost to Light. And then he had to play Quiet, Skull Casual, and then he lost to Koga, if I recall correctly.
Okay.
Mm. Yeah, it's pretty much CR bracket.
Also, OT said the thing about the Nito loss was that it was ultimately inconsequential. It was a round robin where Mitsu still won anyway.
Oh, yeah, I was dumb.
Okay.
So yeah, I give it to Mitsu.
That loss doesn't really mean anything.
So, yeah, I definitely give it to Mitsu. He's like only having like one like considerably like bad loss, just one. While PF has maybe a couple.
And would we give it I mean, will you give the fourth spot to PF over Package just because of off of, like, Package had not having that many results?
I'd give it to PF based off of sure activity.
Yeah, and then his Package's, like, his results, like, in general, like, they're, like, kind of shaky. Like, he got second, and ninth at a MSM. Seventh at a RPI, and then second at the other one.
You also have to remember that PF has multiple wins over OT, while Package only has one.
That's true. So, like, I wouldn't, that's what I'm saying. I would definitely put it.
I would definitely say Package is fifth.
Oh. Now is, like, the part where I didn't get to because it's just too hard. It's like there's Grunk, Wonton, TM, and what my prediction was. Where is that though? And so next best will be running.
I think Quite's definitely an HM. But
are we doing top 8 or top 10?
Top 10.
Mm-hmm. So the next spots would be like Gronk, Marcel, TM, and Wonton. And that's hard.
I think the next one would be either between Gronk or TM.
I was talking with this with Quite on the way back from MSM, and I'd say I'd give that one to Gronk just because he has more showings.
Those are more showings, but a lot of the showings that he's had, he has peaks, but they're not a lot of peaks. They're not a lot of it.
And well, we have to also compare the out of region, because I know Grunk has went out of region a couple times. I don't know about TM once, though, for sure.
I think TM went more than he's been out of region more than Grunk. And then Grunk only went to
Katar. Oh, he also went to the
also remember no, this, that was that,
summer, I think. Never mind.
Yeah, it was summer.
TM has a little more activity. Grunk has the highest peaks, but TM has Q-Town. TM does have Q-Town.
They both also have
one over Marcel.
That does really help him, but then you have to remember that he got a really, really bad placing at Katar.
Who, Grunk? Or
no, TM.
Well, did he get double eliminated or something?
Yeah, I think he went like 1-2.
Oh, he did. Yeah, I remember that.
Let me look again. I think I have the placing on here. Marcel and Gronk got 97th at Katar, and then I think TM got 129th.
Oh my gosh. I see. Yeah, I see.
Let me check again, actually.
I see why you say totally this is wrong. Really hard. Wow. Okay, so I'd say they're even about even when it comes to out of region, too. Would you say that?
Yeah. I'm not.
Maybe. The Q-Town is really good, while the K-Tar is really bad.
And Grunk did all right, but Grunk didn't go to Q-Town.
Hold on. Let me check.
Does Grunk have a win over OT this season?
Yeah, he does.
It was that 1PL, right?
Yep.
Where he reset.
He reset the bracket, and then I think he
Grunk lost. Also has no uprising.
That's true. And then TM's placing at uprising, that's really good.
What did he get, ninth?
He got 13th.
Oh, Grunk only has one 13th. Win. And that was last season. Oh, that was last. Okay, so Grunk. Okay, so that actually frees up a lot. With this, like, new information, Oh, okay, so this season, he reset the bracket, but he lost a tourney to OT still. Okay. I still kind of give it to... I wanted to give it to TM, but TM doesn't have any wins over OT.
Oh, I lied. Yeah, 257th at KTAR.
Yeah, OT just told me that. But okay. I don't think TM doesn't have a win over OT.
Yeah.
Well, Grunk has won. Grunk doesn't have an Uprising or a Katar.
Okay.
I mean, Q-Stown. And TM did pretty well at both of those things that he has for Grunk. So with this new information, I want to give it to TM. That's who I give it to.
It's understandable.
Yeah, but I think Grunk is just behind him by a margin.
That's tough, okay, though. Because because skill wise, I definitely give it to Grunk. But
I mean, yeah, seven, he's got a new main now. He's been really tearing up with it.
Yeah.
So 7 and 8 is TM then Grunk, right?
No, that's 6th and 7th. So yeah, I give it TM then Grunk. So that just leaves Wonton and Marcel. Now, here's the thing.
Wonton has really, really low lows.
He has really, really low lows, but he has really good
really, really high highs. He has really high highs.
He's just like me. Oh my gosh.
You can.
But I think I still give it to Marcel because Marcel still does have better wins than Wonton. Huh?
No, he's just talking . Oh. Okay, so Marcel would be 9. How do you do it at Uprising?
Yeah, 9.
Okay. That's really good. Well, okay, what are his wins like? I know he has some wins over, I think. Oh, wait, So information from OT. OT says Wonton was actually more consistent based this season rather than peak based. So, like, you think about it, like, every time Wonton showed up, he would get some good wins and kind of be like top 5, I believe.
Okay. I meant to say, like, his losses are really, really bad. Like, some of his losses are pretty pleasurable. Yeah. Like, soup. Like, that's one.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
That's just really weird.
OT also brought up Marcel's record isn't too great for his activity. Inactivity, I mean. So I don't know. I'm gonna say I wanna give it to Wonton because of his consistency. He I feel like he has a little bit more activity than Marcel. Marcel does have Uprising, though.
In my honest opinion, I would not put Marcel on this PR. It's no disrespect or anything like that, but his activity is very, very, very low.
Well, yeah. if we put that into account, then we shouldn't put Primax on this PR as well. And then we shouldn't even consider Boost or Boosin.
Oh yeah.
Well, they'd definitely be HMs, I feel like.
Yeah, they can be HMs.
But like not for the PR.
Yeah.
Like I feel like the 10 people that we've named so far is fine. Marcel a little iffy, but yeah, I think it's fine. Actually, if we were to replace somebody with Marcel, I'd say maybe Tarzan.
Possibly Quite.
Possibly Tarzan or Quite. Okay, so OT says, Marcel has the first at PL where he got a double win on me, a win on Mitsu, and a win on Package. But second PL where he lost to Grunk and Wonton. Katar, we did just all right. And Uprising, he did good, but not extremely well. Booster and Roostin's attendance were fine. Primex would hit 8 attendance points. Okay, so the thing about Marcel. Wonton does have a win over Marcel, though. And like those are like kind of bad losses in Marcel, I feel like. Not too bad, but they're still bad losses.
I think it just goes by like how much will we. I think it goes by how much we would punish Marcel for inactivity.
Like,
I wouldn't say punish him exactly too hard. But
I think he'd still be an honorable mention.
I think he'd definitely be an honorable mention. Either a 10 or an honorable mention.
This is hard.
Very hard. And OT was saying Primex's attendance is a bit low, but acceptable enough. I would maybe even give him an HM though. But that is for official PR talk regarding Primex. Okay. So right now, I think for like the one that we're talking about, I give Wonton number 9. And if we're gonna consider Marcel, I give him 10.
If not, I'd put Primex.
So I'll do Marcel / Primex. Okay, so like for the PR that we kind of have this little and whatever it is.
And would we agree that we would have Tarzan, Rusin, and Boost as HMs?
I don't know. Well, Boost did really well at the beginning, but just he kind of disappeared.
That's true.
I think White should be an honorable mention.
I think White should be an honorable mention also, and I think Tarzan should definitely be an honorable mention.
Rusin definitely should be an honorable mention. I honestly am debating whether he should be on the PR.
He doesn't have an uprising, though. Tarzan has an uprising, and same with Quite.
That's true. But
Rusin's only out of region was K-Tar, correct?
Yeah.
And he did how well there?
Let me check.
Also, I don't know. Do aviations count for...
No, I
OT think said aviation kind of inflates his score for the skill keeper, but I don't know about PR. I know he does have a win over PF, doesn't he?
Does he?
Who, Rusin?
Yeah. Oh, Rusin tied 97th with Marcel and Grunk.
Marcel and Grunk, yeah. That's actually
really, really good. And aviations do count, but they have a really low weight.
Huh?
Aviations do count, but they have a very low weight.
Yeah.
Okay, so the question is, would we even put Rusin above Primex?
I think, in my opinion, I would put Rusin at like the bottom of the PR.
I could see that.
Because if we look at Primex results, Primex has, I think, Rusin's results are slightly better than Primex. Because there's been more times where Rusin hasn't gotten top 8 at events and then Primex. That is happening.
And I even feel like he's probably shown up to more stuff than Primex has.
Right.
I'm just assuming that, though. I don't know the statistics.
I think you're right on that, to be honest.
OT also mentions that Rusin's core CR record is better than Primex.
So, I think that is good. I think we should put Rusin at the
bottom. Yeah.
Right, don't get me wrong. If Marcel had more activity, he would definitely be on this list. For sure, no doubt.
He'll probably be, like, top 4.
Considering me for, like, an HM, what's it called? I don't have as much showing as Rusin, I don't think. Actually, no. If we're counting aviation, I don't have much.
You did take the break too, so I think that hurts as well.
That hurts me a lot. But I, thinking about my big wins, I think my biggest wins this season were RP Ike, Alpha, and PF. That's it. Well, I do also have a loss to I have 2 losses to PF. While I have 1 to Alpha.
Okay.
And OT said I pretty much missed the first month and a half of the season. But I'm also a potential PR candidate, says OT. Okay. So if we're talking about HMs, so Rusin will be up there.
Wait, Roos is not a part of our PR.
Oh, Roos is not a part of the PR? Oh, wait. So we're still talking about the PR. I thought we were talking about HMs. My bad.
I think, you know, the last spot should be given to Roosin.
Yeah.
Over Marcel and Primex.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so, like, I think it's, what is, I'm gonna, okay, let me see if this is correct.
And honestly, I feel like this, that's saying a lot because, you know, he doesn't necessarily live around us, but he makes the effort to come out to our events and show what
that's,
he got.
That's actually very, very true.
It's very true.
Okay, so, like, let me see if that's correct. Wizzy first, OT second, Mitsu third, fourth, PF, fifth, Package. 6th TM, 7th Grunk, 8th Wonton, 9th Marcel, and then 10th Roosin. Right?
Yep.
Wait, I thought Marcel wasn't even... What? Huh. Okay.
Roosin will very likely be an HM at least. He has a slot. He has a shot at the PR.
I think he does have a shot at the PR.
I think he does too. I honestly really agree that, with that.
Because his results definitely outshine Primex.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be very happy if he makes it on the PR. I think
you're saying
I think he deserves it.
But I think we're running a little low on time here. So how about we wrap things up with the HMs just really quick?
How many HMs do we have, or four. Can we have?
Four? I think four OT. He'll respond in a second.
I think it would be Tarzan, Quiet, Booty, and I think I give it to Boost.
Oh, okay.
Primex? Oh, yeah, Primex.
So we got Tarzan, Primex, Quiet, and who else?
You.
Okay.
Can we compare results with Chocobro and Rudy real quick?
That's actually really good.
I think Chocobro had this is what I saw. I think Chocobro had like good results in the beginning, and then like his results slowly dropped off a little bit. Like towards the end of the season, I think.
Oh Rudy's snap! RP Ike.
RP Ike. I don't know. RP Ike.
He hasn't really shown up in a big way, I'd say.
Like, I mean, he kind of came through and put a little bit of work in. Just a little bit.
Hmm.
Oh, so we have a sneak peek. And just regarding Chocobro's records, he has a 0-4 record against Isaac Sonic Ninja, which holds him down, and he has that a lack of big really peaks. Bad. So, unfortunately for that. But OT is giving us a sneak peek at the preliminary PR that he presented to the panel. We have 1, Dark Wizzy, 2, Omega Tyrant, 3-4, Money Mitsu, or Prime Fighter, 5, Package Fruits, 6, TM87, 8, Wonton Warrior, 9, Grunk, 10, CCC Tarzan, let's go, 10 through 12. Oh, 10 through 12 is CCC Tarzan, Marcel, Roosin, or Quiet. 13, Kawaii Phantom. 14, Boost. 15, OS. 16, Primex. 17, Me. And 18, RP Ike.
That sounds pretty. That sounds a little accurate.
Yeah.
I'm not sure about Gronk being.
Oh, Tarzan, he has at 9. Oh, wait, my bad. I read that kind of wrong. So Tarzan, he has at 9. And 10 through 12 would be like Marcel, Roosin, or Quiet. Yeah, I like that. I mean, I feel like our list was actually very accurate until TM87. Actually, no, it was actually completely accurate until Grunk and Wonton.
Grunk's activity itself is a little inconsistent, but when he comes, you know, he comes to play, he shows up.
Okay. And he says detailed information will be provided in the panel chat. But that
also,
is...
when we do PR, like when the official PR releases, are we like releasing typical OT stuff, you know, where you give a review on the player and what they did, how to get to their spot?
I think so.
Or how they got to their spot.
I think so. And then hopefully by this Christmas, I'll get a good computer and I'll make a video for it.
Sweet.
That's good.
Which will be very hype. Fingers crossed. Like, let's give your energy to Rudy's parents to get them the PC. All right. But I think that about wraps it up for this episode of the CR Smash 4 podcast. It's been great talking. Glad to have Money Mitsu with us discussing.
It was a pleasure.
Discussing all these topics. Zero Saga definitely was great. The PGR is going to look insane, and I think our PR is going to be, I think it's going to fire a lot of players up. I know me. It's like, that's one of the players. I know I'm going to be fired up about the PR. Like, okay, I got to do better. But we're signing off now, guys. Thanks for those who watched and tuned in, and we'll see you next time.
Good night, everyone.
Night.
Night.